Hello, I am Krishnamurthy Pammi. Let us suppose we estimate a project to get completed at 4 million budget in 12 months. Now, the team identifies all the project risks on the ground. Now, 3 months down the line, the sponsor wants to know what will be the net effect of project risks on the overall project objectives, that is, completing the project within 4 million budget and within 12 months. Let us suppose the team comes back and say, look, we can complete the project at an agreed budget of 4 million, but the confidence is only 65%. Let us understand the powerful message that sponsor takes. If the project is very important for the sponsor, he says, no, 65% is not acceptable. At least I want the confidence to be more than 95%. Then, using Monte Carlo S analysis, we can tell them, look, then we need to have more budget. So instead of 4 million, we need to pump in 1 more million. Then only we can have a 95% confidence of completing the project. Look at the depth of impressive messages that we are talking. The percentage of confidence to complete a project within the stated budget. The percentage of confidence to complete a project within 18 months. This is the message a sponsor or a project management team wants to know. Using simulation and Monte Carlo analysis, we can achieve this. Let us understand simulation using Monte Carlo analysis in detail in this video. Let us understand simulation technique using a simple example. Our example consists of four tasks which are sequentially connected using finish to start relationship. Each task is scheduled to get completed within 1 day at a cost of $100. So 4 tasks, 4 into 100, $400 is budgeted completion. The estimated total duration is 4 days because these are all sequentially connected using finish to start relationship. So this is what is the statistics looks like at the end of 0th day, that is on the estimation day. Now, at the end of the day one scenario is looking like this. It says that some positive thing has happened. We are able to complete task A at a cost of $50 within half day. We use the remaining half day in completing 50% of task B. With this input, the budget at completion is looking like $350 because we save $50 here. The estimated total duration is 3.5 days because we saved 0.5 day here. Now, let us understand another scenario at the end of day 1. We completed the task A at a cost of $75, so we saved $25 here. And we completed this within half day, so we saved half day. Because we saved half day, our estimated total duration is looking like 3.5 days. Because we are able to save $25 here, so our budgeted completion is coming to 375 days. Now let us understand another scenario here. This scenario is we are able to complete only 75% of the task A, so still $25 worth of work is remaining, still 0.25 days of work is still remaining, because of which our budgeted completion is $425 because $25 worth of work we have not yet completed. The estimated total duration is 4.25 days because 0.25 days worth of work we have not completed. So this is how the scenario 3 is looking like. Let's take another scenario. In scenario 4, we completed only 50% of the task A, so still 0.5 day worth of work still remaining, and also another $50 worth of work is still remaining. So there will be over budget of $50 because $100 we spent, so another 50% of task A need to be get completed. So $50 still we need to spend here. So the budgeted completion is $450. The estimated total duration is 4.5 days because another 0.5 day worth of work still remaining. So this is how the scenario 4 looks like. Likewise, we can construct many scenarios for task A alone. Now, if we combine these many scenarios with task B, task C and task D, and first scenario of task A can get connected to third scenario of task B, can get connected to fifth scenario of task C
and 6 scenario of task D. Likewise, we can construct many combinations and permutations, and we can come up with many iterations. Simulation uses a computer software. It simulates the combined effect of individual project risks and other sources of uncertainty to evaluate their potential impact on achieving project objectives. So it performs many iterations using a computer software. And it is typically performed using techniques like Monte Carlo analysis. So simulation performs multiple iterations, probably 10,000 or 1 lakh. It uses historical data. It uses mean, average, mode, and it comes up with a S-curve, okay? So when running a Monte Carlo analysis for cost risk, the simulation uses the cost estimate. When running the Monte Carlo analysis for schedule risk, it uses the schedule network diagram and duration estimates of various activities. If you want the impact of both cost and schedule in an integrated way, then it can use both inputs. The output is just a quantitative risk analysis model presented in the form of an S-curve. See, this is the Monte Carlo S-curve that is resulted after repeating the experiments 10,000 times, 1 lakh times, and considering various factors. The beauty here is it provides predicted total cost on x-axis and cumulative probability on y-axis. So using this analysis, we can obtain the predicted cost and associated percentage. For example, it says that the project can get completed at a predicted total cost of $425, but the associated probability is 36% chance. There is an 83% chance of completing the project within $450. There's a 96% chance of completing the project at the target cost of $475. The Monte Carlo analysis says that if you wanted to complete the project with the available resources, get prepared for $500. Then the sponsor comes and says, look, I only have $450. Then he has to get prepared that there is only 83% chance. So if he puts more money, he can mitigate more risks and there is a more probability of winning or meeting the target. So this is the beauty of Monte Carlo S-curve related to cost attribute. Similarly, we can construct Monte Carlo S-curve for the time attribute or schedule attribute. Okay, on the x-axis, we have predicted total time. So initially, we estimated 4 days of duration, but Monte Carlo S-curve, after conducting various iterations, probably 10,000 times using a computer software and using historical data, it says that, you know, if you want to get your project completed within 4.25 days, there is a 36% chance. If you want your project to get completed within 4.5 days, there is an 83% chance. So it provides the predicted total time and associated percentage chance of meeting the target. Likewise, we can construct Monte Carlo analysis S-curve for very big projects. In our example, we have just taken 4 tasks and therein we got so many scenarios. Now, for our big project, we have many number of scenarios. Using a computer software, we can come up with predicted total cost of completing the project and associated percentage chance of meeting the target. Likewise, we can construct Monte Carlo S-curve for schedule attribute. So we have the time attribute in months on the x-axis and we have cumulative probability on the y-axis. If you want the project should get completed within 18 months, then there is an 83% chance. Likewise, Monte Carlo analysis provides a S-curve and where the x-axis is the predicted total time attribute or cost attribute. On the y-axis, we have the cumulative probability. So, using Monte Carlo analysis, we can perform simulation. Simulation is process of simulating the combined effect of individual project risks and other sources of uncertainty to evaluate their potential impact on achieving project objectives. Simulations are typically performed using Monte Carlo analysis. Simulation is one of the techniques that can be used to perform the quantitative risk analysis, because the quantitative risk analysis is the process of numerically analyzing the combined effect of identified individual project risks and other sources of uncertainty on overall project objectives.
I thank your interest to learn, and I look forward to add more value add sessions in future. Thank you.